Hey, happy Tuesday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I get your latest information on what's going on with Francine. Matter of fact, what you can expect is they're looking at a Cat 2 landfall, showing the winds could be anywhere from 95, 96 miles per hour sustained winds all the way up towards 110, almost to 115. Matter of fact, we're still showing 120 miles per hour plus wind gusts. And I'm showing that this whole region over here, I'm showing that this is going to shift further to the east again. You can see we got a little bit more of an eastern shift. I'm showing it's going to shift more to the east. Matter of fact, the hurricane models is showing that this is exactly going to go right over New Orleans and then right towards Mississippi. So now Mississippi, Alabama, Panhandle, Florida, y'all are in the threat for chances for tornadoes. And we have grown a 5%. I'm showing that's going to raise up as well. Colorado State University sees an uptick for Louisiana and Mississippi on the tornado threat. This is for tomorrow. This is still going to grow all the way into Thursday after that. This system is still going right towards a little more eastern, where it's going to get Mississippi on the impacts on the eastern side of this system. And all this is going to be chances for tornadoes as this goes northern. Plus, we have our next system that is coming. I'm showing we still have a favorable environment in the 20s. I will update you that on the update this afternoon. First, I want to get you the latest information on this system, because this is bringing a lot of winds and a lot of impacts. So thank you for everyone that helps me get the word out on this system. Thank you for following me all these days on these tropical waves coming through. Let me show you the latest information that we have. Now, still showing that it's going to be somewhere around a Cat 1 hurricane on landfall, which still brings winds all the way up from 74 to 95 miles per hour sustained wind. So it's still very powerful. But as it comes towards landfall, you're going to be feeling the impacts from the banding and the winds from the Cat 2 as it weakens down to that Cat 1. Still going to be a tropical storm after that for the next 24 hours. Still impacting Louisiana and Mississippi as a tropical storm. Then still getting blocked and getting all that precipitation and flooding. And you can see from the latest ensembles with the Euro, it did go further towards the east. But at the same time, you see all the hurricane status, all that pink. So you see that eventually that it does win out over the dry air and the shear. And it does intensify, making that stronger landfall. You can also see in the automatic tropical cyclone forecast where it's saying this storm system is going to be. And as you go towards 48 hours, it could either be in northern Louisiana or all the way into Mississippi, which makes a big deal. So whether it's right here by Louisiana, you bring in all the impacts along this area. If it's further over here into Mississippi, it's going further and into portions of Alabama now. And you can see it goes all the way up by Tennessee, Kentucky Valley, and this is where you could potentially get some impacts. Now, I'll show you this because on the eastern side of this is where you're going to get a lot of these tropical tornadoes. Storm surge is still the same and has not changed. It's got to 1 to 3 feet along Texas. Has grown a little bit more of 3 to 5 feet going from southeastern Texas to western Louisiana. You still got that 5 to 10 feet. And once again, they're expecting Vermilion Bay is where a point of impact is going to be for landfall. You still got to 4 to 7 feet and you still got to 2 to 4. The only thing that's a little extra now besides this 3 to 5 is you have 1 to 3 feet now stretching further into Alabama. So we're seeing that from that eastern shift again. Rainfall amounts have shifted east again as well. You can see right here in this whole area, you have 4 to 6 inches in this yellow for rainfall all the way to Alabama. But you also have this 6 to 8 right here going for southern Mississippi and all through southeastern Louisiana. Y'all getting the heaviest amount. And we're starting to see some of that 8 to 12 come on shore as it goes towards Vermilion Bay. This is where you're going to get a lot of that storm surge. And as it goes further to the north, then it's going to start pulling into this direction as well. Remember, all these links are down below. Just click on Francine. You can zoom into your area. The storm surge inundation is still showing a big area going all the way towards New Iberia, all the way towards Baldwin for the heaviest so far. That's been trending that. All this orange is above 6 feet. All this red is going above 9 feet above ground level. 9 feet or greater. Now, the latest on the hurricane models have been showing that struggle as far as the wind shear and the dry air. You can see this in Hurricane Analysis Forecast System A, that it intensifies to 70, 80 miles per hour, holds that off for a little while. Then once you go into Wednesday morning, remember, you can get tropical storm force winds as early as tonight from the banding. It's going to be stronger for tomorrow morning. And then you got the landfall that's happening sometime around noon. This one is showing you still got winds coming very strong as early as 10 o'clock for tomorrow. Started going to the 90s. This is your sustained winds. And then right before landfall, the eye starts going from 90 down to 80s. Now, this is actually your best case scenario out of the two models. But still, this whole area right here, you can see all that brown is the 70s. That white is getting to the 80s. That pink is getting to the 90s right there. And this is sustained winds. So now you have a lot of strong winds going all across this landmass right here, because you can see it on the water here. You can see it on the water here. It's covering the whole area. So now you have very strong winds coming all across Wednesday afternoon. And then Wednesday night is going to start to be pulling towards Mississippi, towards Alabama. And this is where you do get that chance for those tornadoes. This is really going to ramp up your chance for the tropical tornadoes. But you see how it pushes further to the east after it does landfall. And on this, yes, it would put New Orleans right into the crosshairs. So at the last minute, we still see that eastern turn right towards southeastern Louisiana. Now, when you go by your wind gusts, you can see this even gets more powerful. If it starts going by landfall, now you're at 1 p.m. on tomorrow, on Wednesday, you have 117 miles per hour wind gusts. This is out here. All this white is starting to go towards that 80 to that 90. The brown is the 70. Still got the 50s and the 60s as well. Look how it goes on land, and you see all these very powerful winds coming on land. So not only the storm surge, you got a lot of very fast winds. You got very powerful wind gusts hanging around all afternoon long. And look how it moves further to the east and impacts southern Mississippi and Alabama, even the panhandle of Florida. So you got to watch out for those tornadoes as well as you go overnight Wednesday into Thursday morning. Look how it just grows as it goes through Tennessee, northern Alabama, Arkansas, Missouri, southern Illinois, Kentucky. This is 50 to 60 miles per hour wind gusts. And right to the east of that system is right where you're going to have a lot of strong pull in these winds, a lot of wind direction change with height, chances for your tornadoes to grow as well. But you see that eastern track. See that? It don't just go straight up. It goes on an eastern track. Now, Hurricane Analysis Forecast System B unfortunately sees it strengthen up a little bit more. It goes from 80 straight to 101, starts getting some intensification, and it gets a little bit stronger right before landfall. It gets all the way down to 105. So it's almost a major hurricane according to this model. The rest of them is showing it won't be quite this strong. So this literally would be your worst case scenario, showing all these strong winds coming on shore. But you still see that eastern track that comes after landfall with both models. And you can see as far as the wind gust, this one does show a little bit worse on the wind gust. You see how it just varies. The whole boot of Louisiana is going to be covered in these winds. But still showing after it goes on land, still bringing 117. And on land, it still has 104 whipping around. Then it goes down to 90s, which is still very powerful. 70s, 80s, all that as it goes east. Still showing on both of them as it heads north. Look how it fans out with the 50 and 60 miles per hour wind gusts coming with that system. So it fans out further all the way to Georgia. Showing all the way to Georgia is going to feel this 50 miles per hour wind gust. And we have the chances for the tornadoes after landfall. So for tomorrow, for Wednesday, here's your chances for your tornadoes. You have the 2% and the 5%. I'm showing this could ramp up some more. So far, here's your cities and states at risk. Now, as you look right here for Colorado State University, you can see your chances with National Weather Service. But look right here for Colorado State University, showing that it could be an uptick. And I believe this with the very strong winds I see for Louisiana, for Mississippi, and for western Alabama. It could intensify more on your chances for tornadoes for tomorrow. Then overnight for tomorrow, as you go into Thursday, your chances for tornadoes, you got the 5% over here. You still got the 5% over here in the upper Midwest. Is from that next system that I told you was just going to graze a little bit and head north just for some chance for some winds. But still, here's your cities and states at risk for severe weather for Thursday. And over here in the south, this is for tornadoes. And you can see this with the Euro that as it goes on landfall, we still get that block. You still get that system in the northwest. It's just bringing you chances for some winds. And it's a 5%. It's not a big, serious large storm that's going to mess y'all up or do any of that. But you can see afterwards, you get that block over here and all this energy from what's in the east pack, what comes in from Francine, all gets shifted towards the east coast and tries to form up right along the coast. Look at that. Tries to form up something right off the northeast. Thank you so much for your time, everybody. Hope this information does help you know what you need to prepare for. This is a pretty serious storm as it comes on shore, and the impacts is going to last longer than after landfall. So please get ready for this. Please check on your neighbors. I appreciate every single one of y'all. Now, when we go through the afternoon update, I'm going to zoom in a little bit more, and we're going to go a little bit slower with these storms so you can get a timing of what the impacts potentially can be and what time you can start expecting things to pick up. Now, before I go this morning, a little prayer for safety for everyone that is involved. Psalm 91, 1 through 5. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day. Amen. May God bless all of you and keep all of you safe during this time right now with your storm that you're dealing with. And I do pray that God throws all that dry air and that shear in there and quickly weakens this storm. In Jesus' name. Amen. Remember, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope He keeps you safe every single day of your life. Everyone you know, everyone that is around you, everyone that you touch, and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Forever. Amen. I'll see you all this afternoon. Thank you all so much for your help during this time.